Hey friends! Today I want to walk you through how to use my slab templates to make the Squiggle Vase project. These templates are available on my website, I will have a link down below, and can be printed right from your home printer. For this demo, I'm printing at 100% scale, but these projects work at any scale, so you can size up or down your templates in your printer settings to make your finished piece larger or smaller. The templates come with a set of instructions and are a good project for those just getting started with slab building. The first thing you'll need to do is cut out the template pieces. We're using templates J, K, and L for this project. These templates actually belong to a larger kit, so that's why their names might seem a bit random. The first thing you need to do is roll out your slab of clay. I'm using thickness gauges that are a half centimeter thick so that my slab will be an even half centimeter. My best advice for making good slabs is don't move the clay too much at once. You want to slowly flatten out your slab, turning and flipping as you go to stretch the clay evenly. If you press too hard on one section, you can create a weak point there that could eventually turn into a crack. Another thing that will help is to compress the slab with a rib. Any rib will work here, but I like to use this blue Mud Tools rib. By the way, if you're curious about any of my tools, I have a list of my favorite clay tools linked in the description. Now, before I start, my little trick is to dry out the slabs just a little bit. So I put them in front of the fan for about 5 minutes. You can do this step before or after cutting out your templates. This will stop your pieces from being very floppy as you work and result in a cleaner look. Now, this part is totally optional, but I really think it's worth the effort. Do be careful though not to let the clay dry out too much. If you're seeing cracks as you bend your pieces, then they are too dry. Next, you just lay down the templates and cut them out. You want to cut K and J out twice, those are the sides, and L out once. L is the bottom. Okay, so first we're going to assemble the body of the vase. You want to align the pieces from template K so that they are mirrors of each other, like I'm doing here. This is really important to get the sides to line up correctly. Start with one side and score along both edges. If you dried out your slab in front of the fan, you should add a bit of water here to the connection points before attaching them together. If you skip the fan step, you should also skip adding water here, as your clay will be wet enough and adding water risks making your pieces sloppy and difficult to work with. Then you want to score along the edge of one of the K template pieces. Place this piece down on the scored edge to make the corner. You'll notice that the J piece is slightly longer than it needs to be. This is intentional, and you should allow the piece to extend over the edges on both sides. We will trim off the excess later, and by doing it this way, we will get a cleaner edge. Then you want to repeat these steps with the other J piece so that three sides are attached together. To attach the last piece, you should slip and score the same edges and lie it down on top to attach. Perhaps you've noticed that I haven't been moving the piece around very much. That first K piece is still laying in the exact same spot. This project is quite a fragile assembly, and if you wiggle the connection points too much, it can create a muddy and insecure connection. Assembling it this way increases your chances of no cracks along those connection points. Blend the short edge from template K up into the wall of template J. Don't worry yet about making it perfect. We're going to do that later. Right now, the blending is helping establish a strong connection. Now it's finally time to trim those uneven sides. I like to use an X-Acto knife here to get a precise cut. Lastly, it's time to add the bottom. This will be the last template, template L. Once again, you'll notice that the bottom is bigger than it needs to be. This is intentional because you want to attach the piece first before cutting the bottom to size. So you'll want to use a needle tool to mark where to score and score both sides before attaching them together. All of the templates in my kit work this way, attaching the bottom first and then trimming to size, because it's the best way to get clean, straight bottoms. And I also think it's easier than the other way around. Once the piece is well attached, I will then use my X-Acto knife to cut the bottom to size and blend the seam. Now that all the pieces are attached together, it's time to tidy up. I like to use the straight edge of a rib to get those sides nice and neat. I also like to smooth with my finger, and I'll use a paintbrush to get into those hard to reach places. Something I like to do with complex assemblies like this one is to let the pots sit under plastic for 24 hours before doing the final touches and letting them dry. Slowing the drying will strengthen the seams, and when the pot is a bit drier, I am able to smooth the edges much more neatly. Once you're happy with it, your pot is ready to dry out. You want to dry your vase upside down so that the bottom dries out at the same speed as the walls. The drying time will depend on the climate in your area, but I usually wait about a week. This tutorial was helpful for you. If you want to check out the templates, I will have them linked in the description. I'll also include a few extra links, like the link to my online glazing class if you're interested in learning all about glazing, as well as the links to all my tools. As always, if you have any questions, you can reach out to me in the comments below or DM me on Instagram. I love to hear from you. That's it for me today. I hope that you have a lovely and creative day. Bye, friends.